Event tracking lets you track specific interactive elements and content within screens that might not otherwise be tracked. This includes button clicks, menu selections, mobile ad clicks, video plays, and swipes or other gestures. For example, you could use events to track when users click on a button that opens up a helpful tip overlay in a game. This could show you which levels users need help with and whether those tips assist them in the game. To track an event, you must first set up tracking in your account and then attach a method call to the particular screen element you want to track. You can include four parameters within the method: category, action, label, and value. We recommend that you define at least category, action, and label. Categories allow you to organize the events you track into groups, such as videos or social shares. Actions are strings used to describe the event. For example, you could create a category called videos with the associated actions play and pause. Labels are optional strings used to further describe the elements you're tracking, like the name of the video. Value is a numerical variable that you can use to collect customized values, like the amount of time it takes a video to load. When a user interacts with the screen elements being tracked, the values you assign to these parameters will appear in the events report. Be mindful about how you name your categories, actions, and labels so that when they show up in your reports, they will organize your event data in a useful way. When tracking events, each interaction with a tracked element is counted and associated with a user's session. In the events report, total events are calculated as the total number of interactions with the tracked element. For example, if a user clicks on a tracked button in a game 5 times, the total number of button events will be 5. But the number of unique events will be counted as 1. Note that if you want to track multiple elements in a single screen, you'll have to set up separate tracking for each one of those elements. You should also be judicious about what you track. Remember, you want to use event tracking to help increase engagement in a way that leads to monetization. There's no point in tracking common interactions, like a jump button in a game. Collecting that data won't necessarily be useful and could cause you to quickly surpass collection limits in Google Analytics, resulting in incomplete session data. Instead, use your measurement plan to guide which interactions provide the most valuable data for your engagement and monetization goals.